I'm Laurel Baldwin, and this is Kevin Schmidt, and we are the staff of the Whatcom County Noxious Weed Board. And we are here today to show you a little bit how to manage this plant called poison hemlock. We've been receiving a lot of phone calls about it and a lot of concerns about it. And it is toxic, but only if you ingest it. And we're going to show you how you can handle it and control it at your property and not have it control you. So this is how you identify poison hemlock. It's got a nice smooth stem, pretty tall plant, a nice smooth stem with purple blotches. You'll see those purple blotches. The leaves look very much like a carrot when they first start to grow, and then the flowers are these lacy white sort of umbrella shaped flowers. And just make sure you watch for the smooth stem, no ridges, no hairs, smooth with purple blotches right there.
So I'm just going to show you a control option for poisonous hemlock that is very doable. It's just digging it up. You want to keep in mind this plant is poisonous, but it's poisonous if you ingest it. So it's not going to get to you and cause serious harm through your skin or anything, but you do want to wear gloves, long sleeve, just to protect your skin from a rash or things of that sort. But you can just get right in and I didn't get the whole tap root there because this plant's pretty old. It's in really hard soil, but that's enough of the root structure that it's not going to grow from that.
What do you do with the plant after it's dug up? Well, it's pretty easy. You can get them into a plastic bag, and it's important right now because if the plants are starting to seed, you want to prevent that from happening. You don't want them to drop seed. Each one of these plants can drop about 40,000 seeds per plant. So every plant that you dig up is 40,000 hemlock plants that are not going to see the light of day, which is good. So you just want to get a nice hefty plastic bag here, heavy duty contractor bag. Stuff them in. Try not to get them in your face and that kind of thing. Some people are sensitive to the sap on their skin, so you want to be careful about that. Other people aren't. So, but really, again, you have to eat the plant in order to suffer the consequences. So there it is in the bag. And we're going to just tie that up and put it in the garbage, the dumpster. If you're not able to dig up the whole plant, if all you can do is prevent the plant from producing seed, you can go in, take your clippers, clip these flowers off, and then we'll put those in the bag. And then if you want to come back, it'll shoot more flowers up, but you can come back at another time and remove the rest of the root. Poison hemlock comes in, it's a two-year cycle plant, so you're going to have the first year of the plant's life, it just sends up foliage. It's not going to flower, it just sends up the foliage, and then the second year it's going to send up more flowers. This is a second year plant here. Some of these plants have been mowed, so they're a little stunted, but this is a second year plant. It's got flowers coming, and after the flowers are the seed. If you don't have time to work on all your poison hemlock, pay attention to the second year plants. Whatever you can do to keep the plant from going to seed is going to be a good thing.